إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله خيرته من خلقه وصفيه من أوليائه، أرسله ربه بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله، فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا والإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن أمته ورسولا عن رسالته. اللهم احشرنا معه واجعلنا في زمرته وتحت لوائه يوم الدين. اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى، وأحسن الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all praise Him. We seek help and assistance from Him. Whomever He guides, no one can misguide. And whomever He leaves astray, no one can show guidance. Oh Allah, show us guidance, ya Rabbil Alameen. Oh Allah, give us hidayah, give us tawfiq, give us success. Oh Allah, show us the haq, the truth as truth. And give us the power to adopt it and follow it and work according to it. Oh Allah, show us the falsehood as falsehood. And give us the power and strength to move away from it, to stay away from it, ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma ameen. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who believe, have taqwa to Allah. Be conscious. Be conscious of the existence of Allah. Be conscious to Allah as you should be. And do not die except in the state of Islam. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم. O people, fear your Lord. الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة. The one who created you from a single soul. وخلق منها زوجها. And from this soul he created its mate. وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. And from them both he scattered and he spread so many men and women. آدم وحواء, that we all belong to our parents. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام. And fear Allah, the one that you ask one another through. And fear الأرحام, be conscious, be cautious about the kith and kin relationship. إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Indeed, is Allah, Allah عز وجل is watching over you. Allah is looking at you. إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Kids, please do not sit in the entrance. Do not sit in, you're going to be blocking it. No time. Jazakumullahu khair. So please move and leave some entrance, some area for people to get in. You did not move Muhammad Sidani. You did not move Nuh. You did not move Musa. Please move. Leave it. Do I have to remind every khutbah? Move on, please. We have empty spaces in here. Empty spaces in here. Allah yazikum khair. أيها الأكارم دخلنا مدرسة رمضان وحل الضيف الكريم. Here comes the generous guest. The blessed guest, month of Ramadan. فَمَرْحَبًا وَأَهْلًا مَرْحَبًا رَمَضَان وَأَهْلًا بِرَمَضَان. Welcome, most special welcome to the special guest, the month of Ramadan. رَمَضَانُ مَدْرَسَةً. Ramadan is a school, is a university, is a place where we get to for training, for taking a special course, and then excelling and exceeding and being special, and being purified after we graduate at the end of the month of Ramadan. الدرس الأول فيه الصبر. The first lesson that we learn in this school is الصبر, patience, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم called it شهر الصبر. دعاه شهر الصبر في أكثر من أحد من حديث. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he called the month of Ramadan as being the month of patience. وإنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Allah سبحانه وتعالى indeed will give the reward for the patient, for those who practice patience with no limit. With patience, you can be a servant, a true servant of Allah. To do the ta'at, the obedience, you get to be patient. وَصْبِرْ نَفْسَكْ You get a sabru habsun nafs. A sabru habsun nafs is to imprison yourself, is to put a cage for your wild self. This self that we carry is really wild. It can mislead you. It can make you think you are God. You are the one if it's not guided, if it's not caged. And then in Ramadan, we learn how to train this wild self to be such a sophisticated tool for us to take us so fast to Al-Jannah, to take us so fast to Allah Azza wa Jalla. الصوم أو رمضان شهر الصبر والصبر ضياء. When we get patience, we get light in our life. For a student to graduate, he should be patient. Nothing comes overnight. For a worker to get paid at the end of the month or to get qualified for a job, he has to be patient. You expect a baby or something, you got to be patient. You are dealing with your friend, with your spouse, with your teacher, with anybody around you, you have to be patient. Not everything will go the way you want, the way you like. Allah has a plan. And you have a plan and not, they might not be the same. So you got to be patient with the aqdar, with the ta'at, with whatever comes to you from Allah, with whatever orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that could be. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ Allah Azzele is giving us this patience as a very important tool for us. Both of these tools, as-sabr wa salah, we have to really resort to and use. We have to use, be patient. Resort to patience and prayer, especially if you want to be special. أول درس من دروس رمضان شهر الصبر فلنصبر أنفسنا أيها الإخوة نتعلم الصبر مدرسة نصبر على أنفسنا وعلى أهلينا وعلى أولادنا نصبر على يعني We have a lot of bad akhlaq. We have a lot of tendency towards things. We have a lot of frustrations trying to excel, trying to be good, and then we fail. Let's try one more time. Let's be patient. The road of Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs you to be patient. Never give up for shaitan. Any victory of any nation, any victory of any individual will never happen without patience. وَإِنَّمَا النَّصْرُ صَبْرُ سَاعَةٍ You can only be victorious if you are a little bit more patient than your enemy. More patience. That will give you endurance. That will give you a lot of good things. والدرس الثاني في هذا الشهر درس التقوى. درس التقوى. The second lesson that we take, actually the order is not that important, it's just variety of lessons. لا يهم الترتيب يعني. We learn in the month of Ramadan, the second thing is taqwa. Taqwa Allah Azza wa Jalla. ربما كان ينبغي أن يكون الأول. Taqwa Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is that you recognize you are a servant. تعلم أنك عبد. And you recognize you have a master. There is a Lord. And then you will deal like with him likewise. Like he is a God, he is master and you are servant. That is one of the meaning of a taqwa, is to know your limits, is to know who you are, and to know who is your Lord, and to know how to deal with this Lord. Is to know that Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching you over all the time. Is to know that there are enemies for you. The biggest of them is shaitan trying to doom you, take you to the hellfire, the wrong way. And so many other enemies are there. And to know that Allah Azza wa Jalla wants all goodness for you, and you try your best to highlight the side of Allah. وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ Is to tend to go by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you. Is to avoid anything that dooms you, anything that takes you the wrong way. Anything that you know is not good for you. التقوى, self-restraint, self-control. What the meaning of it? We learned this in the month of Ramadan. الدرس الثالث من دروس رمضان درس الجود والكرم والسخاء. وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن. كان كريم طوال السنة صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was the most generous. The third lesson that we get take in the school of Ramadan is generosity. Generosity. Generosity is not only financial, you know, wise, but it has to do with so many other things. Generosity, we learn it first of all من رب العالمين. نتعلمها من الله عز وجل. ألم يكرمنا ربنا جل وعلا في شهر رمضان بخير خلقه بخير وحيه بخير كتبه على خير ملائكته. ألم يكرمنا بدين الإسلام أول ما أكرمنا حين نزل الوحي على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في رمضان. He was the most generous Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us by showing us guidance, by revealing guidance to us in the month of Ramadan. To Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the best of his creation, through the best of his angel, Jibreel عليه السلام. ثم يجود علينا بفتح أبواب الرحمات والغفران. And then he is most generous. Talking during Jum'ah, by the way, can make your Jum'ah void, according to the hadith of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. So, he was the most generous by sending the best of his prophets, the best of his deen, the last, the seal of all the prophets. He is most generous to us subhanahu wa ta'ala by showing us all of these opportunities that every single Muslim feels. We feel it. نشعر نتلمس بل نكاد نلمس رحمات الله عز وجل وبركاته نازلة علينا. We almost touching the blessings of Allah عز وجل coming to us. He is so generous by showing us this. يريها للعاصي, يريها للتائب, يريها للصالح. فرص عظيمة أكرمنا الله تعالى بها. ثم أكرمنا بالعتق من النيران يعتق كل ليلة في رمضان لله في كل ليلة من رمضان عتقاء من النار. So generous that he emancipates people from the hellfire. Frees, issues this amnesty to people who deserve to be in the hellfire. He issues them amnesty. عفو عتق سبحانه وتعالى. نتعلم الجود أولا ما نتعلمه من رب العباد ثم من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أكرم الخلق. And then we learn this generosity from النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. الذي ما سئل عن شيء قط فقال لا أبدا. صفوان بن أمية يوم حنين سأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأعطاه, ثم سأله فأعطاه, ثم سأله فأعطاه. قال الزهري أعطاه 100 من الإبل ثم 100 ثم 100. قال الواقدي حتى صار له ما بين جبلين من الإبل والنعم. This person, Safwan ibn Umayyah, he asked, one day he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give me more. He gave him 100 camels, more, another 100, more, another 100. And he kept asking the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam giving him until he got a valley full of camels and cattle. قال ما طابت نفس بهذا إلا نفس نبي. He said, there is no soul that would be that generous except the soul of a Prophet. أشهد أنك رسول الله. And he give the testimony of faith. سأله صحابي البردة وقد لبسها محتاجا إليها. He got a gift صلى الله عليه وسلم, a cloak, piece of cloak. And somebody asked him, could you give it to me يا رسول الله? And he got it صلى الله عليه وسلم. He just got it. The lady gave it to him right now on the spot. And he took it while he was in need for it. He asked from somebody, could you give it to me? He told him, give me 1 second. And he went inside. And he folded to him in a nice way and he gave it to him. أكرم الخلق صلى الله عليه وسلم. Shouldn't we be generous in the month of Ramadan? يعطي عطاء الملوك وهو في نفسه مسكين صلى الله عليه وسلم مسكنة التواضع. He gives like kings and he gives like very very rich people, even though he in himself صلى الله عليه وسلم he led the most humble life عليه الصلاة والسلام. أفلا نتعلم الجود منه صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. وبخاصة في رمضان especially in the month of Ramadan we are not going to be generous now in Ramadan so when let's be generous with ourselves with our families with the people around us generosity is not it is by finances and money and everything but more importantly by your akhlaq تفضل بالعفو تفضل بالصبح على الآخرين جد بالكرم جد بفضل علمك بفضل خبرتك be generous to share what you have with others be generous to like good for others to like for others what you like for yourself do not live only for yourself that is a form of generosity if you share with others ثم الدرس الرابع درس الحلم والصبح وضبط النفس The fourth lesson that we get in this school of Ramadan is forbearance and self-control and punctuality and being in control of everything, starting with yourself and then your time and then everything around you. We learn it. It's so clear. We are exercising it right now. We are being trained to this right now, to be in control of our shahawat. نتعلم ضبط شهواتنا. You don't eat right now, Fajr. Oh my God, I woke up late. 2 minutes after Fajr, I cannot eat. Why? Because that is the course. You have to train yourself. Even if you have to continue to the end of the day, not eating, not drinking. But it's too late. So we learn this. Shouldn't we be in control of our ego, of our pride, of our evil sides of our soul, shouldn't we be in control of that? If we manage, may I ask the brother inshallah to move forward, this side, تَفَسَّحُوا يَفْسَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Please move forward to this side inshallah, because the room is full. Make room for those who are coming inshallah. So let's be, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ حَلِيمٌ Allah said in the Quran, know that Allah is all forgiving and all forbearing, subhanahu wa ta'ala, حَلِيمٌ ينسبون له الصاحبة والولد وهو يرزقهم ويعافيهم. He sees his creation, some of his creation. Talking ill, you know, bad things about him by saying he has a wife and he has a child or son. He sees all of that and he continues to give them. He continues to take care of them because of his hilm, his halim. So we need to deal with that. We need to forgive each other. We are not angels. We are not angels. We are going to make mistakes with others. And others are going to make mistakes with us. So let's live with this kind of forgiveness and hilm, being patient with each other, being generous enough to forgive each other, being forbearant enough to let go of things. How could we live with each other if we remember everything that the imam did and the sister did? And my wife did, and my husband did, and the friend, and the co-worker, and the teacher, and the government, and the other group. We will not continue together like this. Let's let go of things. This is the month to do that. Allah Azza wa Jalla, let's go of so many things for us. Allah Azza wa Jalla yarham wa yahlum. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, let's go of the so many things that for me that I know. Wallahi, if you are the judge over yourself. Probably you will not, a fair judge over yourself, you will not let go of your stuff. You know, if you look from outside of your good things and bad things, and how much did Allah give you, and how much you are giving in return, really, if you look at it fairly, you might not qualify for the forgiveness according to your own standard, but the standard of Allah Azza wa Jalla is higher than any other standard. He is wa'lamu. You have to be sure, and you have to give the knowledge that Allah is ghafoor, haleem. Allah is ghafoor, all forgiving and all forbearing. Shouldn't we be likewise? Let's learn from رب العزة جل وعلا هذا. والصيام جنة. Fasting is a protection for me and you. So it will give me and you and everybody and Muslims, it will give them that. It will give them protection against anything. فإذا كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يفسق ولا يسقط. If you are fasting, the day of your fasting, Do not be involved in anything that's useless. Do not be involved in anything that's sexual. Do not be involved in anything that is... Do not even raise your voice. إِذَا صُمْتَ فَلْيَصُمْ سَمْعَ وَبَصَرُ فَلْيَصُمْ سَمْعُكَ وَبَصَرُ Let your hearing, let your eyesight be fasting as well. Fasting is not only from food and drink. This is just to, for you to exercise. Yes, I can. That's it. Yes, I can. I can be in control of myself. If I can be in control of myself in terms of food and drinking and this daily routine, I can be in control of the evil things and bad things and the things that are not fit for me as a human being, as a Muslim, as a person. وَلَا يَسْخَرْ. Even if you are provoked, فَإِنْ سَأَبَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ. Even if you are provoked, somebody insults you, somebody fights against you, you still are in control of yourself, not pacifism, but trying to be, to go to the highest level of self-control. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. The meaning of the ayah. Turn away from the ignorant. Do not get down to the level of the ignorant. Do not be that light of a person that somebody who's driving next to you can ruin your day. Somebody who says a bad word or disrespects you or anything that's minor can ruin your day. Do not be you know, strong enough. Be more in control of yourself and your emotion, that none of these will provoke you. None of these will take you out of the state of kamal, perfection, or near perfection that you are trying to put yourself in. ثم الدرس الأخير درس الإخلاص. The last lesson of the collections of lessons I thought of. Obviously, there are hundreds of lessons that we learn in Ramadan. دروس عديدة مئات الدروس. إنما هذه أربعة أو خمسة دروس أنا جمعتها يعني. الدرس الأخير الإخلاص. Sincerity. الإخلاص لله عز وجل. وكم من عامل بل في الصيام ورب صائم ليس له من صيامه إلا الجوع والعطش. How many fasting people that will get nothing of their fasting but hunger and thirst. Hunger and thirst. That's what they take of their fasting. وكم من مسلم ليس له من إسلامه إلا الشك يعني. وكم من عامل ليس له من عمله إلا الصورة الرسم منافق. So we have to be careful that it's not only by saying certain things or doing certain things, even if good, they are good in reality, that will be enough for your salvation. No, they have to be done right and they have to be purely sincerely for the sake of Allah. So you can do a lot of good, right things. They are right, the action is good, but sincerity is not there. You do it for the sake of others, for the sake of yourself. You do it for showing off. God. We learn sincerity, ikhlas in Ramadan when we fast, and nobody's aware, completely aware of our fasting, because it's completely between me and you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody knows about it, so that develops and should develop sincerity. لا نصوم كما يصوم الخلق، الناس كلهم صيام. إنما لولا نصوم بنية أنه لو لم يكن على وجه الأرض غيري لصمت. وأقوم قيام الليل لو لم يكن من مسجد ولا جماعة ولا أحد يصلي لقمت. So I fast. I made قيام الليل. And I do all of that only and sincerely for the sake of Allah so much so that if no one else around me, if no Muslims, if no community, if no masjid, I would still fast and make salah and make قيام الليل and do all of that. That then this will be done for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. One final time I ask inshallah my brothers to move. I see a lot of empty spaces in here. So please, inshallah, move forward towards this side. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يرزقنا الصبر وأن يرزقنا الجودة وأن يرزقنا الحلم والصفح وضبط النفس وأن يرزقنا الإخلاص في رمضان. اللهم إنك عفو كريم حليم عظيم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفرونه وهو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين الآثمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله رب العالمين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد عبده ورسوله الأمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One final thing. شيء أخير لنخرج من رمضان يعني دخلنا الآن دخلنا رمضان ولله الحمد وأتانا رمضان وسلمنا الله عز وجل لشهر رمضان فلا نخرج منه إلا وقد استفدنا وتعلمنا شيئا إلا وقد تغير فينا شيء إلا وقد اكتسبنا ولو شيئا. We got to Ramadan. We made it to Ramadan. Allah عز وجل gave us the opportunity and chance. We have been making dua to him. Oh Allah, make us catch Ramadan. Here we are. One month, one week is gone. But still, inshallah, three more weeks are coming, a little bit more. So please, let's not let Ramadan go without acquiring at least one thing. Without moving on towards goodness even 1 inch. Moving away from bad even 1 inch. Let's get something out of Ramadan. Let's not get in Ramadan and then out of Ramadan just like nothing. Let's get some change. Let's change our condition. Let's change our heart, make it purer. Change our tongue and make it purer. Let's stay away from the F and S word and that and all of these words. We curse everything around us, from the door of the car, from the phone that's not working right, from the computer that's freezing, from... Let's be purer in our heart, in our tongue, in our eyes. Let's learn something and let's get something good in our way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we go faster. أذكر ببعض الأنشطة اللي عندنا في رمضان. Number one thing, I need everybody to stay for a few minutes. We are, not we, Allah Azza wa Jalla is giving us an opportunity to spend for His cause. We will have a quick fundraiser inshallah after Salatul Jumu'ah. Your attendance is so important. الحضور مهم جدا يا أخواني. فرصة طيبة إنك تحضر الخير. Now we are calling for خير. So attend. Even if you're not going to pay, not a problem. Just attend this chance, inshallah, to be part of it, inshallah ta'ala, at least by attending, at least by making dua for those who donate or for the masjid or for any goodness, inshallah. 5 minutes or 10 minutes after salah, please stay there, inshallah. The second thing, we have package of activities in Ramadan. Get the chance to see the details of those. One of them, most important thing coming, sharing Ramadan is coming in July 15th. Please take the chance to register and see the details over there at the table outside, inshallah ta'ala. And if you have friends, you can find them, but make sure you register first, inshallah. The third thing, and that's been introduced to the community, بنقدم هذا الجنة لأول مرة مسابقة في القرآن الكريم للجالية. أرجوكم يعني نتفهم الكلام. It is للجالية. A Quran competition for the community. I hope. Every single Muslim will participate. It's not for kids, not only for kids. It's not only for those who know Quran and Huffaz. It's not only for the Arabs. It's not only for certain specific like Islamic school. It's not only for those who have been Muslims, but it's for everybody. Wallahi, and we compete in everything. When Black Friday comes, everybody compete. This season for sale, here is a competition for Quran. So we have so many levels. I know as I'm speaking now, أنا بتكلم الآن من إنسان بيفكر لا, I'm Uzbek, it's not for me. I am a Pakistani, I am a convert. It's for everybody, please. Take the chance to look at the details. The goal of it is to have a community revolving around Quran. Reading, reciting, listening, competing, and everything. And we will make it fun, inshallah ta'ala, we'll have a ceremony. Just get the chance to see the registration out there, inshallah, it's sponsored by the Quran School at BCIS, and I hope everybody will participate. We have even levels for the converts, from 3 surahs or 5 surahs, the short surahs, all the way to the very, very advanced people. Get the chance to register. I guarantee you, if you register, you will go and read and review your Quran, and you will compete in the Quran. وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون. A very personal, humble raja. يعني I ask you to please consider just looking at the levels and try to be part of that, inshallah. The final thing is we have a daily iftar. Yes, the weekend iftar is attended by majority of the community, but we have daily iftar as well. We're trying to get together as a community. And instead of eating at home, which is nothing bad with that, but eat your food and come with the community. You will talk to someone else. You will get to know him. You will get to know her name. You see her always in the masjid, but you don't know her name. This is a chance. You'll be sitting next to her. You will be sitting next to him. You will talk with each other. You will build this relationship with your community. Bring your food and come. Don't have food? Not a problem. Just come. Inshallah ta'ala, every day here in the masjid. As-salallah tabaraka ta'ala an yubarika lana fi shahrina. May Allah Azjala bless our month. May Allah Azjala bless this community. May Allah Azjala bless us and make us blessed, ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit al-haq aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fi al-akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. ربنا هيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. هو الله show us guidance يا رب العالمين. هو الله forgive our sins يا رب العالمين. Make us generous. Give us patience. Give us generosity. Emancipate us from the hellfire يا رب العالمين. هو الله make us patience and make us forgive those who are around us so we qualify for your forgiveness يا رب العالمين. Make us sincere for your sake. Make us sincere in all of our sayings and all of our actions. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل والسر والعلن يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على خيرتك من خلقك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
Kindly check your cell phone and pager, please. Turn it on silent mode now, please.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala salati, hayya 'ala falah. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة، من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا بيع فيه ولا خلة ولا شفاعة، والكافرون هم الظالمون. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم، لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم، له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه، يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم، ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء، وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يئوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. اللهم. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله. الله. inshallah, is 10 minutes. I promise, inshallah, as much as